Oh, time for a donut. I'd like one of those, please.
Here, freshly baked goods for our friend and helper.
Oh, that really hits the spot.
Vehicles, we have a collision involving two cars. Car 2, can you take this?
Car 2 here. We're on our way.
Understood, Car 2. Sending the coordinates to your GPS.
A vehicle has broken down at a potentially hazardous spot. Can someone please secure the site?
Car 4 here. Haven't you got any real jobs for us? Okay, we'll go if we have to.
How gracious of you, Car 4. I've just sent you the coordinates.
Attention all emergency vehicles. We have an accident causing a traffic jam. We have to create a rescue lane for the emergency vehicle as quickly as possible. The civilian drivers can't do this on their own. Car 4 here. We're on our way. We'll provide a little road safety education. Roger, Car 4, but remain polite. We'll see.
Calling all cars, we have a broken down vehicle in a somewhat hazardous spot. Which of you can go and take a look?
Emergency vehicles. As you know, a famous head of state is using a short section of our Autobahn. We need one more vehicle for the escort.
Car 11 here. We'll volunteer. Should we get you an autograph?
No thanks, just the escort.
Roger, we're on our way.
Thank you. dispatch. Please come in. Car 2 here. What's up, Car 2? The driver of a suspicious vehicle is resisting the traffic check. It is a white coupe. We've sent you the number plate. We are in pursuit and are moving north. Copy, Car 2. I will notify cars in the vicinity. According to the computer, the white coupe is a stolen vehicle. Proceed with caution. Roger, dispatch. Dispatch, please come in. Car 2 here. Dispatch here. We're breaking off pursuit. The suspect is driving too fast and too recklessly. The risk was too high for us and for everyone else on the road. Copy, Car 2. In the meantime, we've started a nationwide search for the vehicle. Return to the station. You're still needed here. Thank you. you, Car 6. Report to head of operations. Emergency vehicles. There are reports of a person on the carriageway. This is a life-threatening situation. Car 11, can you take this?
Car 11 here, on our way.
Thank you. I will send approximate coordinates to your GPS. Two lorries are involved. As far as we know, there are no casualties, but there is cargo in the road.
Understood. Is there more detailed information on what was being transported?
At least one of the two lorries was loaded with teddy bears.
Dispatch, could you repeat that, please? It sounded like you just said teddy.
I'll take care of checking the personal details before you speak to the people. In the meantime, you can take care of something else. I've recorded the personal details. Everything okay so far?
Hello. Is there a problem with your car?
Oh, hello. Well, I'm having a spot of car trouble of sorts.
How can you have car trouble of sorts?
Well, it's a bit embarrassing.
Well, it can't be all that bad.
Yeah, well, I've run out of petrol.
Really? You don't keep an eye on the fuel gauge? There are quite a few petrol stations along here.
Yes, but...
But what?
Have you seen the price of petrol?
You're not serious, are you?
Well, yes. Petrol is always so expensive at the petrol stations along the Autobahn. I thought I could make it a bit further.
Road safety must always take priority. You do realise that, don't you?
Of course. I know I sometimes take things a bit too far with my thriftiness. My wife is always saying so. I'll be on my way shortly. I'm just about to call a friend who'll bring me a canister of petrol.
Right. My colleague's going to call a towing service for you. At your expense, of course.
Is that really necessary?
Yes. You're carelessly endangering road traffic here.
I should have tanked up. This is going to cost a fortune now.
And to make sure you really learn your lesson, I'm going to issue you a ticket as well.
No, not that as well.
Otherwise, you'll never learn your lesson. You should listen to your wife more often. The breakdown lorry will be here soon.
Vehicles, we have a suspicious car. It is allegedly swerving across the road. Who is in the vicinity and can go and take a look?
Car 11 here. We are already on the Autobahn. We'll take care of it. Dispatch, send us the vehicle details and we'll keep...
Hello.
Hello.
Show me your license and registration, please. Thank you. I'll have a look. Have you taken any drugs?
Drugs? Not me.
Have you been drinking?
No, I haven't had anything to drink.
I have to give you a warning. But don't let this happen again.
11, this is dispatch. Please come in.
Car 11 here. What's up, dispatch?
I've just sent you some coordinates. Drive to the rest stop. There's a vehicle on fire there. The fire service has already been alerted.
Roger, dispatch. We're nearly there. Dispatch, please come in. Car 11 here.
What's up, Car 11?
The fire is under control. Our colleagues from the fire service are taking care of it. The owner of the vehicle claims that his fuel gauge was defective, and he wanted to check the fuel level using a match.
Oh, man.
Please come in. Car 2 here.
What's up, Car 2?
The driver of a suspicious vehicle is resisting the traffic check. It is a white coupe. We sent you the number plate. We are in pursuit and are moving north.
Copy, Car 2. I will notify cars in the vicinity. According to the computer, the white coupe is a stolen vehicle. Proceed with caution.
Roger the dispatch.
Dispatch, please come in. Car 2 here.
Dispatch here?
We're breaking off pursuit. The suspect is driving too fast and too recklessly. The risk was too high for us and for everyone else on the road.
Copy, Car 2. In the meantime, we've started a nationwide search for the vehicle. Return to the station. You're still needed here.
There's been an accident. A vehicle has spun out of control for unknown reasons and collided with another vehicle. The cause could be a soiled carriageway. There are no serious injuries. You can take this.
cemetery. Officers are blocking the section in question, but keep your eyes open. Calling all emergency vehicles, since our
I'll take care of checking the personal details before you speak to the people. In the meantime, you can take care of something else. I've recorded the personal details. Everything okay so far?
Thank you.
Hello. You are Mr. Lung, correct?
That's right. You must want to ask me about how the accident happened.
That's correct. Can you describe exactly what happened?
Of course. My girlfriend and I were driving along the Autobahn as usual. We are always relaxed drivers, so we are almost always in the outside lane. Suddenly, the car in front of us started to swerve out of the lane. It wasn't going too fast or anything. In any case, it span around and I slammed on the brakes, of course. It didn't look like the driver had the chance to get the car back under control. I wasn't going too fast, and I was also keeping a safe distance. But I couldn't come to a stop in time either.
Could an oil slick have been the cause, perhaps?
Yes, I probably wouldn't have thought of that, but now that you mention it, shortly before the accident, I noticed a strange dark spot on the tarmac. I thought I hadn't driven through it, but it seems I had. That'd also explain the long braking distance.
Where is this spot?
Just back there.
I should take a look at it. Okay, that's everything. Thank you for your help. Hello, Mr. Fogt. How are you feeling? May I ask you a few questions?
Phew, yes. I'm just happy that nothing else happened. Feel free to ask me.
Yes, you were really lucky. How did you spin out of control?
I was driving along at a normal speed, and when I tried to correct my steering slightly, I realized that the car wasn't responding. Then I began to spin out of control. Counter-steering did virtually nothing. It was a bit like driving on ice.
Well, we can rule out ice in this weather. And are you quite sure that you weren't driving too fast?
Oh, quite sure. You can even ask the other parties involved in the accident.
All right, I'll do that. Thank you for your help. It is an oil slick. It's a miracle that nothing worse happened.
We should inform the fire brigade so that they can take care of the oil.
We have hazardous objects on the road. Who's taking over? Attention, we have an urgent call. Two lorries have collided. It's not known whether there have been any injuries at this point. Who can take over?
Too recklessly. The risk was too high for us and for everyone else on the road. Copy, Car 2. In the meantime...
I'll take care of checking the personal details before you speak to the people. In the meantime, you can take care of something else. I've recorded the person...
Hello, Mr. Junker. What happened here?
My cargo? I'm sure it's completely ruined. This could cost me my job.
One thing at a time, please. First, describe how the accident happened.
What do you want me to describe? I'm sure the bloke who drove into me was occupied with something else. People like him ruin the reputations of an entire profession.
Please, start from the very beginning. Tell me, what happened?
I was sitting at the back of the traffic jam, and the bloke just rammed into my lorry. He only stepped on the brakes at the last second.
So, he failed to notice the traffic jam and crashed into your vehicle, is that right?
I just said that. This stretch of road is so straight, you can't miss anything. If I lose my job because of him...
You seem to imply that the other driver was distracted. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, I know my fellow drivers. They live in their cabs. You don't want to know what else they occupy themselves with. Trimming their toenails and reading the paper are the most harmless amongst them.
On the contrary, I'd love to know. Can you prove any of this?
No. How am I supposed to prove it?
In that case, you should be very careful making statements like that. All right, I've heard enough for now. Thank you. Hello, Mr. Kirsch. That was quite a crash, wasn't it? Do you mind if I ask you a few questions anyway?
Yes, go ahead.
How did the accident happen?
It was probably my fault. I'm sorry.
Fair enough. But that doesn't answer my question.
I failed to notice the traffic jam. That shouldn't have happened.
And how is it that you didn't notice the traffic jam? It's a straight stretch of road, after all.
I was, briefly distracted.
Were you perhaps reading the newspaper, and that's why you didn't see the traffic jam?
I'm not a big reader. I prefer to listen to the radio.
That brown stain on your shirt, is that coffee?
Could be.
The stain seems quite recent. Were you eating breakfast while driving? Is that why you were distracted?
You caught me. If I don't eat it while driving, I won't complete my rounds in time.
Imagine you'd crashed into a car instead of a lorry. There could have been fatalities. You've been grossly negligent. I don't need to know any more. You'll be held accountable for this. The paramedics will take care of your injuries.
A lorry seems to have lost its load. We don't know what it is exactly yet. Car 8, can you take this one?
Car 8, it will set up straight away.
Meanwhile, we know what the lost load is. Washing machines.
We need another vehicle for general traffic checks. Who would like to volunteer?
Car 2 here. We'll do it if everyone else is starting off. We're on our way.
Roger. Thanks, Car 2.
This is dispatch. Please come in.
Car 11 here. What's up, dispatch?
I've just sent you some coordinates.
to block the slip lines and cover them urgently so that no more vehicles can access the Autobahn.
Car 10 here. We've just arrived and we'll take some of the slip roads. Car 6 here. We're also on our way.
Copy, Car 10 and Car 6. Coordinate your efforts and get moving. The situation is critical.
Understood. Will do.
Units, we have hazardous objects on the road. Who's taking over?
vehicles. There's been a collision on one of our routes. According to our information, there are no serious injuries. Who can see to this? A tanker has collided with two lorries. The tanker is apparently lying on its side and losing its liquid cargo.
Great. That means we'll have to change clothes after this.
That is quite possible, Car 2.
Then today is our lucky day. What kind of liquid cargo is it anyway?
Whole milk.
Do we have time to grab some biscuits?
Negative, Car 2.
You don't spoil us all, do you? Seems to have lost its load. We don't know what it is exactly yet. Car 8, can you take this one?
Car 8, he will set up straight away.
Meanwhile, we know what the lost load is. Washing machines.
vicinity. A tanker has collided with two lorries. The tanker is apparently lying on its side and losing its liquid cargo.
Great. That means we'll have to change clothes after this.
That is quite possible, Car 2.
Then today is our lucky day. What kind of liquid cargo is it anyway?
Whole milk.
Do we have time to grab some biscuits?
Negative, Car 2.
You don't spoil us all, do you?
Service has already been alerted.
Roger, dispatch. We're nearly there. Dispatch, please come in. Car 11 here.
What's up, Car 11?
The fire is under control. Our colleagues from the fire service have taken... The owner of the vehicle claims that his fuel gauge was defective, and he wanted to check the fuel level.
Oh, man.
Confused. We're bringing him to the station.
Roger, Car 4. Good work.
Calling all emergency vehicles. Since our team of plainclothes officers have fallen ill, we need a replacement. Who can take this on? Car 4, yeah. We'll do it. Chasing speeders in comfortable clothes. Who can say no to that? Return to the station, then, to change your clothes and car. We don't need to be told twice. We're already on our way.